It's old Shug here wishing you a happy holidays.
Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas. You know, every year at my wife's house, I have to do a little skit for the family. This year, I did a little takeoff of the poem. It was the night before Christmas. So mine's a southern account. It's called "Twere the Night Before Christmas." I hope you enjoy it. I'm going to have a special guest of mine come in here and read it for you. Merry Christmas, everybody.
For the night before Christmas and all through the shack, not a creature was stirring, not even that black cat. Them white socks was hung on the potbelly stove, hoping Santy would come in that sled that he drove. The kids was all hunkered up a tight in their cots, hoping that Santy would bring them a lot. Ma's fixing biscuits for that feller in red, and we're both dog-tired as we lay down our heads. About that time in holler, I heard such a tizzy. I jumped up so fast I got woozy and dizzy. I stuck my head out the window as far as I could. It sounds like a scuffle out there in the woods. The moon was so bright on that blanket of snow, you could see shadows and shapes. It scared me, you know. Then you ain't gonna guess what I saw in the air. A magic gold sled being hauled by a reindeer. I couldn't believe it, and Ma called the law. I yelled her to stop. I said, "It's just Santa Claus. Them reindeer are pretty and they seem pretty tame." Then Santy jumped up and he called them by name. "Hey Leroy, now Floyd, now Harold and Kitty. Up Horace and Wilmer, on Bobo and Dixie. To the top of the coop and right by the smokestack. They got a moving with that big old toy sack." Then they took to the sky. I never seen nothing quicker. They's as fast as old Dooley selling his liquor. "Dooley, slipping a dollar. Dooley, trying to make a dollar. Dooley, give me a swallow and I'll pay you back someday." Them duds he was sporting was red with white fur. I'd never wear them, that's for darn sure. He had him a load slung over his shoulder and an ash in his boot that would start to smolder. He had on some glasses, made his eyes look real big. His cheeks was flushed and he was dancing a jig. He was grinning and humming, enjoying himself. He was working him alone. He didn't have him no elf. I got to talk to the union people on that one. Now, he ain't shaved in a while and his beard was all white. He looks pretty smart because he's smoking a pipe. He eats all them cookies, so he's got him a belly, and when it laughs, it jiggles like muscadine jelly. Big feller he was, at least 6'2". I smiled when I seen him, and you would have too. He gave me a nod and a wink of his eye. Not a bad feller for a northern guy. He ain't all that chatty, he's busy, I reckon. He left all them presents, and he looked up a second. He took his finger and he laid it right up by his nose. And then he shot up the chimney. Last we saw was his toes. Now, Santy hopped in that sled with a grin on his face. Them reindeer took off like a darn NASCAR race. Then I heard him holler as he took to the sky. "Merry Christmas to y'all, and y'all have a good night. Merry Christmas, everybody."